have some questions come in. I received two questions last night, so I'm going to deal with one question this morning, and then I'll touch on the other question this evening. So the first question, and let me get my assistant. This may sound like a very controversial topic, and it's going to sound like that because it is. Are you ready? How does God view a queer or transgender person? Will they be saved? Question for you. Which sin do you hate the most? Don't give me that generic good Christian answer that all of them. You know, and I know, there are certain things that you hear about that upset you more than others. You understand what I'm talking about? And I'll be the first one to be transparent. Can I do that? I get very upset when I hear about any man who beats his wife. You are not a man. If you lay your hands and abuse and commit domestic violence against your wife, you are not a man. And if you're a man that does that and you have issue with me saying that, I'm happy to talk to you privately. A man, according to Ephesians chapter 5, is one who loves his wife sacrificially as Christ loved the church and gave himself for her. I should have had at least one amen from at least one woman. Women, how much do I have to prime this pump to get you on board with me? My hand's about worn out priming this pump. Work with a brother. In that same chapter, in verse 22, it says, wives also submit to your husbands. And women bristle at that. I got Nathan primed. I just don't know if it was for the right thing. But follow me in this. Follow me in this. What woman, what godly woman who has a godly husband who is loving her sacrificially and treating her with the utmost dignity, respect, and appreciation and value, what woman in her right mind would not want to submit to a man like that? Is that fair? So my point is, we have certain things that get our ire up, right? That trouble us. Another one is exploitation and abuse of children. Now, I don't think that using some good disciplinary action and spanking our children is abuse, because there is a scientific fact that has not been published. Would you like to hear it? There are receptors that run from the ear to the brain in children. And those are like grown over, clogged over, thorny pathways. And when we as parents sometimes send information through those receptors in the ear to the brain, the information doesn't get through. But there are receptors that run from the gluteus maximus to the brain, and they're like a 4-lane interstate highway. And I know when I was growing up, my mama kept a little traffic on that interstate. I turned out okay, depending on who you ask. But should we abuse our children?